Hey y'all, hi. I'm so excited to finally be filming this video today. It's been a long time coming. It's something I've needed to do for a long time. And then since the seed of the idea to do it this way started sprouting in my mind, I've been really excited to share it with you. So here's the deal. I had begun to notice and to be really increasingly frustrated by the fact that I wasn't wearing the majority of my clothes. I wasn't wearing my clothes and I wasn't inspired when I looked at my closet. And that's frustrating for me because I've chosen my clothing very carefully. I love my clothes. They all spark joy. So I really thought about it. I sat myself down and I think that I figured out why I have the problem. I think I got to the root of it. And then I conceived of a new organizational system for my clothing that I hoped would be the solution. So in this video, I'm going to explain the problem that I was having and explain why I think I was having the problem. I'm going to show you the footage of myself reorganizing and decluttering my entire closet. And then I'm going to give you an update on how the new system is working because at this point it's been in place for a couple of weeks. If this happens to be your first time watching me, then welcome. I'm so glad you clicked on this video. I'm glad you're here. My name is Hannah and I really love beautiful things. I love beauty products. I love clothing, but I feel like if I'm going to spend some of my time and my energy and my resources on choosing which things to buy and then buying them, I want to actually use them. But sometimes, weirdly, that's harder than you would think that it would be. So sometimes it requires me to kind of sit back, assess the situation, do some reorganizing, and that's what this video is about. If that sounds good to you, I hope you will subscribe to my channel. And now, let's go ahead and get into the meat of the video. Y'all, I am beyond pleased. I am like ecstatically excited to tell you that this video is sponsored by Poshmark, which is just the best. I love working with Poshmark because I'm an avid user of the website and I have been since well before I even started a YouTube channel. As many of you already know, I love shopping secondhand, especially for designer pieces, really nice pieces, the kinds of things that I can't afford to buy when they're brand new. I have a closet of nicer things than I could afford to own if I wasn't a secondhand shopper. And a lot of those things that I own that you'll see in the video as I'm going through my closet, a lot of them are from Poshmark. I also love selling my gently used or unused clothes and accessories from the comfort of my own home. I don't have a ton of totally unused clothes and accessories lying around because again, I try only to buy things if I'm really going to love and use them, but you can't always predict the future. Sometimes you just can't know. For example, I bought these unbelievably stunning shoes from a Poshmark seller. Can you believe it? Like, they're just perfect. I bought them because I thought that I might wear them to get married. They're not quite the perfect fit for me that I thought that they would be, so I'm going to resell them on Poshmark. It's a very streamlined process selling on Poshmark. They make it so easy. The thing that I appreciate the most about it is that Poshmark creates the shipping label for you. For some reason, that feels like a huge stressor to me, having to like figure out how to ship something, and it's really, really easy when you're selling on Poshmark. As part of my closet organization, I came across some beautiful pieces that I realized that I wanted to sell. So I just posted a new crop of things in my Poshmark closet, and I'll link that down below. You can also download the app from the link that's in the description box underneath this video. Click through, download it, and then from the app, you can check out my closet, check out other things on Poshmark, browse the site, and you can also sell your own things in your closet. You just open the shop in the app, your shop, and then you click through to list something and you can like take pictures of your item right inside of the app, brief description, and then boom, you're good to go. You can post something literally in moments. If you've never used Poshmark before, I recommend downloading the app and then just getting in there and looking around and kind of seeing how it works. And then if you decide to declutter and reorganize your closet for the winter, like me, you can have that in the back of your mind as a way to potentially make some of your money back when you come across unused or gently used beautiful things in your wardrobe that you realize when you're decluttering, you're pretty sure that you're not going to wear again. Speaking of not wearing your clothes, let's revisit the problem that I told you about at the very beginning of this video, the precipitating issue. So I realized that I wasn't wearing my clothes and I wasn't feeling inspired by my closet. It bummed me out because clothes are some of my most delightful treats on this earth, right? I love fashion. I just love beautiful things, and I particularly love garments. There was like a dissonance between how much I know I actually love my clothes, how much I love my wardrobe, and how I was feeling when I entered into that space, when I kind of like engaged with my stuff. So what was the problem? I sat myself down, I thought back over the course of my life, I looked at my clothes, and this is what I decided. There are two main issues. The problem is essentially twofold. The first thing that's happening right now in my life that has changed my relationship with my wardrobe is working from home, and not just working from home, but staying at home almost all of the time, which we're still doing. We're still in a state of semi-quarantine because there's a baby in our household and she's too young to be vaccinated. So we're being very cautious, and I'm just continuing to spend almost every single hour of every single day for weeks and then months on end in the house. So there are a lot of beautiful items of clothing in my wardrobe that I am not wearing because they just aren't ideal for working from home. Even though they make me feel great when I put them on, and I hope that they make me look great when I put them on, I'm saving them to wear when I'm out. They're just slightly more formal, things that are just a little bit more polished, things that need to be dry cleaned, pants, trousers that need to be dry cleaned. I don't want to just wear those things on a lark around the house and then, you know, get a stain on them or get them really sweaty, get them dirty, get them mussed and have to go through the process of caring for them, washing them. I don't want my nice clothes that are specifically for being out in the world to get worn out right now when I don't require the thing that they have to offer. This might seem obvious, but it really helped me to articulate it to myself that there's a big percentage of my wardrobe that I really love, and I'm not skipping over it and failing to wear it because I don't love it. I'm skipping over it and failing to wear it because of the really specific circumstances of this time, but I haven't done anything about that. I hadn't like gone through and separated those clothes from my other clothes. So all of these clothes that are really beautiful but currently irrelevant were like in amongst my other clothes, making me feel a little bit disoriented and distracted whenever I looked in my closet. And that leads me to the second of the two reasons that I came up with for the problem that I was having, not feeling inspired by my clothes, not wearing my clothes. There was an organization issue. The way that I had organized my closet just wasn't working. And I'll talk you through some of the ways in which I had thought I should have it organized and why I was continuing to stick to that and what I was realizing wasn't working about that and what I changed. So one of the principles on which I based my previous way of organizing my closet, the one that I realized wasn't working for me, comes from Marie Kondo, who I've learned a lot from. I really appreciate the life-changing magic of tidying up, and I'm glad that I read it and I'm glad that I incorporated many of those principles into my life and into my thinking. But one of the things that she talks about that I thought was brilliant at the time and that I employed, and then over the years I've realized isn't working for me, is the idea of always having all of your clothes out, visible, and available to you. She talks about not storing things seasonally, but rather having a place for everything and having everything in its place in your closet and just not wearing the things that aren't season appropriate. I liked that idea when I first came across it because I didn't like the feeling of having like a bunch of clothes that I didn't remember or wasn't using stuffed away in the back of my closet. I liked the idea of doing away with that kind of like corner of shame, like garbage bag full of shame, like clothes that I'm like, I don't want to deal with this right now. I'm putting it away because that garbage bag of shame or those garbage bags of shame had kind of plagued me through my young adulthood and early adulthood. So when I read that, which was years ago at this point, I changed my ways. I tried to find a place for everything in my drawers and on my clothing racks, and I tried to always have everything there. So I'd have my winter coats hanging there even when it was summer. I think that there is something to be said for that, especially if you have enough space. But the thing that I realized when I sat myself down and I really thought it through is that That is one of the things that hasn't been working for me. We're just living in these two rooms in our friend's house. These rooms don't have closets because they're not designed as living quarters. They're supposed to be a dining room and a living room. So we're just making it work in these slightly unorthodox spaces, which is totally fine with me. But I think that it's important for me not to adhere to principles that make sense for somebody who has like a proper bedroom and a proper closet, because they may not translate. They may not be what I need right now. So I determined that I needed to put away some clothes, put them in a little bit of a semi-storage. I needed to kind of clear the space and make it so that everything that's out, everything that's looking at me, looking back at me when I look into my closet, is something that I believe I might realistically wear right now. So that represents a huge shift in thinking for me in terms of how I keep my clothes, because I've gone years where everything was always out. But there's another thing that I decided to try, and it too represents the bucking of a teaching of Marie Kondo. So one of the things that I learned from reading The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up is that if you hang everything on hangers, it's hard to see what you have. I think that she talked about seeing a lot of people's closets where everything was just stuffed so tightly in next to each other on hangers that it didn't feel like things had breathing room, and the people who owned those clothes, they just couldn't find their stuff because their closets were just packed with way too many hangers. So she really espouses this like folding and packing in drawers method. And she basically says anything that can be folded in a drawer should be stored in a drawer with this like file folding method. And then you should only hang on hangers things that need to be hung on hangers in order to keep them wrinkle-free, like to keep them in good shape. It does make sense, and it made sense to me at the time. And that's another thing that I've been striving to do for years. I've been trying really hard to stick to that file folding system. It does kind of work for me in some ways. And I do fold things like that and keep them upright in the drawers like that. But I don't have enough drawer space. So it's another thing that's like good in theory, but like I don't own a dresser. I just have this piece of IKEA furniture with these wire drawers. So I was trying to always fold and file in the drawers my clothing, and then everything else was just on this one clothing rack that I had hanging there. But I didn't have enough drawers, so then I would end up file folding and stacking things on this like glass shelving unit. The organization would very quickly get out of hand. Like I didn't have like a drawer for pants, a drawer for t-shirts, blah, 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 blah. It was like I was just folding and sticking things in wherever I could fit them. There was no organizing principle. There wasn't a place for everything and everything in its place, because I was trying to, again, adhere to this principle that I think would be great if I were living in a different kind of space, if I were living under different circumstances, but it just wasn't a good fit for my lifestyle, for my resources. So I decided to hang everything up, totally flying in the face of everything that Marie Kondo has ever taught. But I have to give credit where credit is due here. I was very inspired by a YouTuber named Emma Hill. She does these videos. She's like a style YouTuber. She does fashion videos. And she does these videos, usually she does it twice a year, going into the fall, winter, and then again going into the spring, summer, a wardrobe changeover. In the summer, she stores her winter coats and her sweaters away in Tupperwares, and out in her closet, she only has her summer clothing. And then as it starts getting cool, as the weather starts to change, she stores her t-shirts and her shorts and her summer dresses, and she takes her sweaters and coats back out and hangs them up. And every year she films the process, and she goes through and talks about this process of gently decluttering, but more importantly, just like switching over your wardrobe from one season to the other. So clearly she inspired me to allow myself to pack away the things that I'm not wearing, but she also hangs almost everything on hangers. And in one of these videos that I was watching recently, she specifically said, people say not to hang your knitwear. And I love my knitwear, you know. I am very precious about my sweaters. I just want them to last forever. I want them to stay in really good shape. And I've always been terrified of hanging my sweaters. I've been afraid that they would get misshapen because they'd be like sagging off of the hangers. And Emma Hill, in her video, she was like, people say that, but I've never had a problem. She was like, I've never had a piece of knitwear be negatively impacted by having it hang on a hanger and it makes it so much easier to see what I have. And I was like, you know what? I'll just try it. I'll just try putting my sweaters on hangers and just see if it really does destroy them in the way that I've always thought that it did. Spoiler alert, it doesn't. They're fine. They're fine. They're amazing. They're hanging. They're living their best sweater lives on hangers as we speak, but I'm getting ahead of myself. To recap, the problem, I wasn't wearing my clothes and I wasn't feeling inspired by my wardrobe. The reason for the problem, I'm working from home right now and staying home almost all the time. I almost never go anywhere. So a lot of my beautiful clothes don't make sense for me right now. And the organizational system really wasn't working for me. File folding of clothes, stacking things in piles, only having some things hanging up, it wasn't working. I decided to hang all of my clothes on hangers. All of my clothes. So I'm talking about like t-shirts are in there hanging on hangers. Hoodies are in there hanging on hangers. Like things that I've always thought, oh no, like you fold that stuff, you put it away in drawers. Every single item of clothing of mine, except for my pajamas and my underwear, every single item of clothing is hanging on a hanger like it's in a boutique. And at the same time, I decided to weed out everything that I'm confident that I'm not going to wear during this fall and winter for any reason. I'm going to try to keep only the things that I realistically might actually put on my body out on the hangers. So the first thing that I did was to take everything, every single item of clothing, out of its drawer, off of its hanger, and put it on the bed. Because I was trying to do a lot of things at once. I was trying to weed out the things that I wanted to put away in boxes. And again, there are multiple reasons why I might put something in a box. So it might be because it's not seasonal, and it might be just because it's not the right time of life for that thing. But at the same time, I wanted to weed out clothes that I think that I don't want to keep. So most of my pieces are really nice and in good condition, and I take good care of them. And some of them, I just realized that I've had them for a long time. I'm not really wearing them. I'm probably not going to give them the love that they deserve. And so I want to find them a new home. So in order to make sure that I was thorough, I took everything out of my quote unquote closet. I piled it all on the bed. Then I had to get some furniture out of the way because I wanted to bring in another clothing rack. And this brings me to something that I know that I need to mention, which is that I have clothing racks lying around because I used to own and run a small business where I sewed handmade clothing and sold it. So we are rich in clothing racks, if in nothing else. There are a handful of clothing racks in the garage at Julia and Oliver's house where we're living. And so that was not something that I had to make a decision about, like if it would be worth it to me to buy another clothing rack because I already had one. So that's another thing that made this system make sense for me. And the same is true of hangers. We just have so many hangers. We have hangers upon hangers upon hangers because we used to need to have hundreds and hundreds of hangers to run our business. And we still have those hangers. Again, they're in the garage. I knew that I was still going to need to use that piece of white wire IKEA furniture, the one with the drawers that slide in and out, to store my underwear and my pajamas. But I wanted to get that glass shelf out of there. It's where things were collecting. Piles of sweaters would end up on there. And I just didn't want those shelf surfaces to be there to collect things any longer. So I took it out and I brought it in here and I put it in the background of my videos. Usually there's a plant right there, but I'm fostering this kitten right now and she just figured out how to get up onto those shelves. So I've had to get the plants out of the way so that she doesn't chew on them. In fact, this plant, I've had to move it as well. I just put it back for the video because she's sleeping right next to me right now, but she's figured out how to jump from this glass shelf right here over to the other shelf right there. And so I had to take all of the plants off of all of those shelves. Here she is. I know I can't mention a kitten sleeping next to me without holding her up. Are you a cat or a bat? You're a cat? I thought so.
Here you go.
Uh-oh, now she's awake. Are you making trouble? You wanna jump down?
You can go down.
Okay, so after I brought this glass shelving in here, I cleaned the floor. I vacuumed the floor. I took the opportunity because, you know, it's tough to get back there. Then I brought in the second clothing rack from the garage. I put it in place. I brought in a bunch of extra hangers. And then I started going through my clothes category by category. So this is when I was really taking myself to task. I was looking at each individual piece of clothing and I was asking myself, am I actually wearing this? Am I going to wear this within the next 6 months? Do I feel realistically like if I look at the closet and this is in here, that I'm actually going to reach for it and put it on my body for any reason within the next 6 months? Some of my nicer pieces, my more editorial or formal garments that are tops, I kept because I wear them in videos. So it's like the only thing that I get dressed up for. Sometimes my, you know, cotton ruffle sleeve blouses, things that are just a little bit more glamorous, I'll put them on to film certain videos. So I kept some of those things out. They're like part of my wardrobe for YouTube. But pants, formal trousers, and really fancy dresses, all of that stuff, I asked myself, are you really going to be wearing this? And the answer was no. So I folded that stuff and I put it away. If I knew that I wasn't going to be wearing something, I also asked myself, am I going to wear it in the future? So do I want to store this and keep it for after quarantine is really truly over and I'm going out and about? Smidge, why are you being a troublemaker? I really tried to make sure that I wasn't keeping stuff for the future that I probably wasn't realistically going to wear even after I was able to start going again to events, going out and going to dinners and stuff like that. And I did come across a couple of things that I was like, you know what, this is really beautiful, but even if I were going out into the world and doing all of the things, I still wouldn't be wearing this. And so those things are the things that I decided to sell. I went through category by category, hanging the items back onto the hangers, first putting things on hangers. There were a lot of things that hadn't ever been on hangers that I had to put on hangers. And then I hung the groups of things up onto the clothing rack. And then I kind of looked at them up there and I was like, okay, all of these are things I'm going to wear. I went through and checked each item individually. So I did like all of my blouses, all of my sort of like sweaters and hoodies. Then I did all of my pants, all of my dresses, etc. Oh, there actually is a third type of garment that I decided to store in the wire drawers, and that's workout gear. I whittled down my workout gear. There's some of it that I decided to let go of, some of it that I felt like was really totally worn out. And then the stuff that I'm keeping, I did do the file folding system and put it away into one of the wire drawers. So that stuff isn't hanging on hangers. And then I went through, and this is to me the most satisfying part, and I organized it mostly by color. So I organized the tops. I have all the tops on one rack and all of the pants and dresses on the other rack. The tops I was able to organize fully by color. I thought about it for a little while. I thought about putting like my sweaters together and then my blouses together, which is what I've always done. Historically, it's what I've always done. I'm not sure if that's another thing that I learned from Marie Kondo or if that is just the thing that made the most sense to me. But this time I decided to mix every type of top, mix it all together, but organize it by color. So I ended up with this gradient that goes from gray to beige to cream to white, then to sort of like a purple, pink, then like a bright orange, yellow, green, print, and then into the black clothing at the end. I find it very aesthetically pleasing. I wasn't able to organize my pants and dresses quite as well because there isn't such a rainbow of colors among those garments. I also felt like with outerwear, dresses, and pants, it made more sense to group things together according to the type of item. So I have some of my leggings hanging up. I put my fashion leggings, or like the leggings that I wear as clothes, I actually hung those on hangers. I've never hung leggings on hangers in my life, and I felt totally ridiculous doing it. And then I was so pleased with myself after I'd done it. So I have the leggings all grouped together. Jeans are all grouped together. Dresses are all, I have like the lightweight dresses all grouped together. And then I have like the knit dresses all grouped together. So I did a little bit of color organization there, but mostly on that rack, the principle has to do with the type of item. I also moved my laundry hamper to a place where it's much more accessible. There are some logistics that make a lot more sense now. I have my underwear and my workout gear and my robes and pajamas in these wire baskets, these sort of like drawer baskets. Then I have all of the tops beautifully organized by color. And then I have the pants organized by style. Then I have the dresses and the outerwear at the end. I'll show you the before and after as well. To me, me, even though the space is still not like some incredible minimalistic closet. It's still not the Sex and the City closet. It's still, you know what I mean? It's not some sort of aspirational home interior moment. Even though it's not that, I feel like there's a huge difference in just the atmosphere, like the tone. When you look at how it is now, it just feels more streamlined. It feels calmer. It feels more attractive. It feels more like something that I want to approach when I am about to get dressed in the morning. I felt immediately happier about my clothes after I had done this. I just had the feeling that every single garment was being given its due, being kind of given special treatment by being put on a hanger and hung in place. And that feeling of specialness is really important to me because, again, I've put money and time and thought and care into the selection and acquisition of these pieces. I've always just wished that I had a system that would allow me to treat them in a way that honors how special they actually are to me. And I'm pleased to report that it is going swimmingly. I am so happy about it. I have been file folding my pants into those wire drawers for so many years, and it always felt like there were things shoved in the back that I couldn't see. And in order to look at my pants, I had to pull out one drawer and look at it, and then I had to pull out the next drawer, and there were always some pants hanging. So my pants were like in three or four different locations, and when pants were washed, I didn't quite know where to put them away. Now it's like I look at the pants section of my closet, I look at them hanging there, and I can see at a glance every single pair of pants that I feasibly might put on my body, including leggings, sweatpants, jogger style pants, denim, like everything. So I never look. What I used to do is I would like look at my pants hanging and I would be like, well, these are just my formal pants and my linen pants. I want comfortable pants today. So then I would like go digging in the drawers. There, I can't even express to you what a weight off of my process it is to look at the pants hanging there and to know that that's really, it is all of them. There's not a pant in a drawer, not even a legging. The other thing that's amazing about it is that everything, I'm gonna stick with pants and talking you through it, because pants are kind of like the hardest for me. It's just, I feel like the part of my body that pants clothe is the part of my body that I find the hardest to clothe. So I'm always feeling like I don't have pants. I have all these beautiful tops that I wanna wear and I don't have pants to match them. I don't have comfortable pants. I don't have pants that are flattering. But I actually do have a number of pairs of pants. I have like lots of pants. And so it's been like a revelation to me to look at that part of the clothing rack and be like, these are literally all my pants. It's also been amazing to look at it and to have every single pair of pants be a pair that I realistically, feasibly could or would wear right now. There's nothing hanging there that's like, oh, this is just here, but I'm saving it for later. Everything is like some comfortable denim, some cozy sweatpants, some wear around the house leggings, some stretchy joggers, some soft flowy linen pants that I really love to wear day in and day out. That's everything. It's like all gooey center. It's all of the good stuff that I've known that I had because I bought it. I picked it and bought it. I knew it was in there. I just couldn't find it, see it. I couldn't hold it all in my mind palace. And so I was struggling. When I was approaching my messy closet, I was struggling. The other thing is that this system forces me to take the time to put things away because a garment is either on a hanger or it's not. And if it's not on a hanger, I can't put it in its place. And if it is on a hanger, then there's no reason not to put it on its place. You know what I mean? So there are no piles of things lying around anymore because I'm not doing that thing where I'm like folding some things and just like sticking them onto a shelf or like cramming them into a drawer or something. When my laundry comes off of the drying rack or out of the dryer and I'm putting it away, it's like it's either in the laundry basket clean or it's hanging on hangers on the rack because where else would it be? So that's all amazing. But the real success is that I have been wearing more of a variety of outfits. I've been wearing clothes that I know that I wouldn't have worn if I hadn't reorganized my closet. The moment of getting dressed has become a real treat. It feels calmer and clearer. It feels more like the experience that I imagined for myself and that I wanted for myself when I acquired each one of these articles of clothing. And that would have sounded like a fantasy to me a month ago. Like if you had told me a month ago that I was going to have that, I would have been like, how though? Like how? Tell me your secrets. So I decided to sit down and tell you my secrets. And I hope that this has helped some of you. I hope that if you have even one of the issues that I was having, I hope that there's been something that was able to kind of like reorient or like give you a new lens or flip a switch a little bit, maybe help you figure out how to organize stuff better so that you can have that positive experience that you deserve to have with your beautiful things. Again, I am very grateful to Poshmark for sponsoring this production. Don't forget that the link to click through and download the Poshmark app is at the top of my description box underneath this video. You can also click through and check out the things that I am selling, the things that I posted in my closet. Most of it is my stuff, but I also recently helped my friend Amaris declutter her closet, and I've listed a couple of things from her closet too. She is a different size from me. There are a couple of really beautiful pairs of jeans that I sure wish that I could fit into, but I can't because Amaris is a lot smaller than I am. She just has a really unique perspective about style. So there are some beautiful designer dresses like a Lily Pulitzer dress and a DVF dress in my closet as well that came from Amaris. If you have any closet organization tips, if there's something that was like the magic bullet for you but that I didn't mention in this video, please let us know in the comment section down below, because I'm curious to know if there's anything else that I might add to my system. But also, I know that different situations require different systems. Like that's one of the things that I learned from this. The things that work for a lot of people don't work for me because of my specific circumstances. So maybe you'll have something to offer someone else who's reading the comments that I couldn't offer you. So let's discuss. Thank you so much for being here. And don't forget to take extra good care of yourself today so that you can be the most effective version of yourself as you do your work in the world.